Up to this point, in this sequence of 22 videos, we have looked at two uses of fractions. Fractions for part of a whole, and fractions for the quotient of two whole numbers. In this video, we will look at ratios, a third use of fractions. A ratio is used to compare two different sets of objects. Here we have 9 tiles, and here we have 15 chips, and the ratio of the number of tile to the number of chips is 9 to 15, and we write that as a fraction, 9/15. And usually we write ratios in lowest terms, so the ratio of the number of tiles to the number of chips is 3 to 5. This lowest terms tells us that for every 3 tiles, there are 5 chips. If we compare the number of chips to the number of tiles, for every 5 chips, there are 3 tiles, so the ratio of chips to tiles is 5 to 3, or 5/3. Notice that in comparing two sets, it is very important which set is mentioned first. Ratio of the number of tiles to the number of chips, we've seen, is 3/5, and the ratio of the number of chips to the number of tiles is 5/3. Whenever a first set is compared to a second, and we get a ratio, and then we compare the second set to the first set and get a ratio, these ratios will always be reciprocals of each other. We have used a ratio here to compare two different sets, but it is also possible to compare the different numbers of objects within a given set. For example, the ratio of the number of orange chips, 1, 2, 3, 4, to the number of blue chips, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, is 4 to 6, or in lowest terms, 2 to 3. Ratios can be used to compare the parts of a fraction bar to the whole bar. The ratio of the number of shaded parts to the total number of parts is 2 to 5, or 2/5. The ratio of the number of unshaded parts to the total number of parts is 3 to 5, or the fraction 3/5. Comparing part of a bar, whether it be the shaded part or the unshaded part, to the whole bar is the part-to-whole use of fractions that we have seen in the first 20 videos. We can also compare the number of shaded parts and the number of unshaded parts. Let's look at that. The ratio of the number of shaded parts, 2 in this case, to the number of unshaded parts, 3, is 2 to 3, or 2/3. Similarly, the ratio of the number of unshaded parts, 3, to the number of shaded parts, 2, is 3 to 2, or 3/2. In 1 and 2, we compared part of the bar to the whole bar. In 3 and 4, we're comparing the shaded part to the unshaded and the unshaded to the shaded. Let's see how the information we have just seen can be used to solve a word problem. If 1/3 of the students in the school drama club are boys, what is the ratio of boys to girls in the club? Now this fraction 1/3 tells us about part of the set, 1/3 of the whole set. So we'll use a 1/3 bar. This shaded part of the bar represents the boys. The unshaded part represents girls. The whole club is represented by the bar, and the ratio of boys to girls is 1 to 2, or the fraction 1/2. There are over 300 million people in the United States represented by this region, and the ratio of the number of people under 18 years old, represented by the red region, to the number of people 18 and over, represented by the region out here, is 1 to 3, or the fraction 1/3. The ratio 1/3 can be used to find the fraction or percent of the U.S. population that is under 18 years of age. The 1 to 3 ratio can be represented as a bar with one shaded part and three parts unshaded. So we'll label the parts of this. This is the under 18. Let's just put down less than 18. Here we have the 18 and older. Say 18 and older. And up here we have the whole population. That's represented by the whole bar here. So the ratio of the number of people under 18 years old to the number of people 18 years old and older is 1 to 3. We'll say the ratio is 1 to 3. And we can see that a bar with one part shaded out of 4 represents 1/4. So 1/4 of the people, 1/4, or 25%, if we wanted to use percents, of the population is under 18 years old. Let's look at ratios for solving problems. On a school field trip, the ratio of chaperones to students is 2 to 15, or 2/15. If there are 75 students on the field trip, how many chaperones are there? So we're going to have another ratio here. It'll be the number of chaperones to the number of students. So we want to find the number of chaperones that will go with the total number of students so that these two ratios are equal. Now the denominator 15 can be multiplied by 5 to get 75. So to keep equal fractions here, we want to multiply the numerator of 2 by 5. So we're going to have 10 chaperones. Two equal ratios is called a proportion. Proportions occur in solving problems frequently in mathematics, and when three of the four numbers are known, any three of the four, the fourth number can always be found. The dots mat can be used to practice obtaining ratios in lowest terms. We use this mat and the fractions from the spinner for earlier examples of products of fractions times whole numbers. So we're going to be moving from this octagon to another one, depending on the color. We're not going to use the fractions. So we have red, so we're going to move to red. We just use this to get the color. Now we've got 4 by 4, so there's 16, so the ratio is 2 to 16. So we have a ratio of 2 to 16, and in lowest terms this is 1 to 8. Spin the spinner. Okay, we got white, so we go over here. Now the ratio is 16 to 8. So 16 to 8 is the second ratio. And in lowest terms, this is 2 over 1, or 2. This activity can be played like a game with two or more players. A player's score on each turn is determined by the ratio. For a ratio less than 1, the player receives 1 point. And for a ratio greater than 1, the player receives 2 points, and the player receives a bonus of 1 point if the ratio is not in lowest terms and can be written correctly in lowest terms, as in these two cases. You are watching the last video in a sequence of 22 videos on using fraction bars for teaching fractions. If you have watched these 22 videos, then I think you might agree that fractions can be taught with understanding.